Welcome back to It Bioscope Sessions with me, Mary Kate Masilela. It's a throwback Friday, the last one of January 2019. So before we go to the movie, which we're doing, Come Tearing, by the way, I'm just going to remind you to subscribe to the channel, like, and of course, do comment. I love hearing from you guys. I hope you enjoy the interview.
Good morning, listeners. Nice to be with you guys.
Please tell us about the film.
Yes, thank you very much. Come Terrain is a film of Afrikaans, a typical South African comedy that we started writing early last year, February, March. And our whole goal was to make a movie that all types of South Africa can enjoy.
Yes.
So Come Terrain is a comedy. The experience we had from the people that already saw the movie was they've been laughing from the beginning till the end of the movie. So it's a movie about camping, which is a big tradition in South Africa.
Yes.
And like I explained to you when we had a chat earlier, back in the day, camping was only for white people.
Yes.
But things are changed. I mean, things are changing in South Africa, and you get so many more black people that are starting to enjoy camping. And it's not only for people that have caravans, because, that is was the main thing a couple of years back. But, tents are becoming very, very cheap. And you can go for a weekend with a tent and go enjoy yourself at so many different resorts in South Africa. So Come Terrain is all about camping and all the stuff that happens on a campsite.
This movie is very relevant for people in Mpumalanga because we're very much surrounded by nature. And I grew up from primary to high school. We always went out to camping. And I end up taking that traditional with my friends, and we adapted it years later, even outside from high school. So we do go camping every couple of years. It's like you said, it's very much cheaper to do camping than going to Cape Town or something and then paying for hotels. It's very much relevant to people here. Will the film be released here?
Good. Actually, Come Terrain has been released today. I think the first screening in most of the cinemas is 10 o'clock today, and it will be released countrywide throughout New Metro, Stack Nico, and also the indie cinemas. I had a look at our lineup, and I know there is in Nelspruit there is a big mall there with the cinema, and Come Terrain will be playing out in Nelspruit as of today, and I think Secunda as well. I don't know this your coverage covers Secunda, but I know Secunda's also got a cinema that will be screening Come Terrain.
What inspired the film?
Look, for me, I grew up as a camper. My dad loved camping. We had a caravan. So I grew up with camping, and Marcus Miller, people would know Marcus from Igoli and Villa Ruasa, and he's now playing in Seven Alone. A good friend of mine, he approached me and says, listen, I've got the story. I mean, he and Teresa Bernardi, who's also a well-known actress, with when they were together, they went camping, and being celebs, they always like to find the corner in a campsite where nobody can see them. And while they were sitting in this corner, they were looking at what's been happening on a campsite and find all these funny things that happened. And when he approached me, obviously, grew up with a camper, I really fell in love with the story. And we started writing. We started writing, the things, that happens on a campsite, the funny stuff. That is basically what inspired it.
This movie talks about questions and things which are happening in South Africa today, it's quite relevant, even though it's comedy. That's why I like comedy, the joys of it. The whole thing about the Afrikaans family being angry that the black family took their favorite spot. Do you think, like, because right now in South Africa, like, we are having the land dispute and stuff like that. Was it important for you to make something out of that being relevant to South Africa today?
I think so. You know, this is Kamperan is my 9th movie that I produced. Mm. You know, a couple of movies back, I did a movie called Robert Diamante, which I wrote the story. Mm. You know, in Robert Diamante as well, you know, it was all about high school kids that didn't get along, black and white, a white mm. group and a black group. And there was a lot of conflict at school, and the school decided to send them to this boot camp. And obviously, the lesson out of that was working together, mm. you know, we can be much stronger than fighting each other.
Yes.
And, you know, I like telling stories like that. Now, in Kamperan, it's exactly the same. I mean, you laugh. I mean, from the word go, I mean, Jan Fushia is a Stura Afrikaans guy. I mean, he's been camping on this campsite, specific site, on this resort for 12 years. And this year, when he got to his site where he camps, Mr. Kumalo and his family was busy sitting up. So you can imagine the frustration from his side. Obviously, camping right next to each other, he was playing his guru music, and the Kumalos were playing Requato. And it's hilarious, you know, what happened from there. And then, you know, the next day there's a fishing competition, and you know, who's ending up next to each other? The Fushia, Jan Fushia, and his Kumalo. So obviously they sitting next to the fishing water, and during the night, I mean, they become this amazing friends. I must say there was alcohol involved,
yes.
Which is quite funny.
Of course.
So they was, you know, they were sharing Jan's brandy, and Mr. Kumalo was sharing his pot because he was catching all the fish, and they become such huge friends that, you know, after the holiday, they decided to go visit each other. So again, with the racial tension and all the stuff that's going in South Africa, through this comedy, you know, we would like to show people that, you know, it's okay. It's okay to be friends. It's okay to although there's so many differences, we can be friends. We can enjoy ourselves, and you know, those kind of things. And you know, that's important for us.
Oh, that's great. The film, I really love this film so much. I love South African films when they're different, because there are some South African films which like duplicating Hollywood films. It's very important for us to stay within our story. What kind of films do you would like to see this year coming out on 2017 besides yourself, like the storylines?
I think you're definitely right. I mean, you know, we mustn't try to duplicate Hollywood. Hollywood is Hollywood. Hollywood is America. South Africa, you know, the film industry in South Africa is growing so much at the moment. And, you know, we've got our own identity. We've got our own crises. And I think comedy is a big factor. We need to get to laugh again. And the nice thing about Kamperan, it doesn't matter which kind of person you are or personality you are. There's so many characters in Kamperan, different storylines, that somewhere you will see yourself and you will be able to laugh at yourself. So, you know, I think, you know, good movies this year that can make people laugh, that can make people think. But again, I think the whole bringing South Africa together, I think we got it right in 1995 with the sports. Sports is always a good thing to bring, you know, it doesn't matter what racial or color you are. I mean, that brought us together when we won the World Cup. But it seems like we lost it after the game. So, movie and films are such a powerful media that you can use to tell stories and to bring people together, to sit in the same cinema, and doesn't matter what race you are, is to laugh at what you are seeing on screen and walk out and become closer. I think that those are the kind of stories that we need to tell in South Africa.
Yes, I think people shouldn't be afraid to speaking out the truth. You know, sometimes when you're running away from the truth, it makes the fire even much more harsher. You know, like,
for sure.
I think we need to face it, and then that's how we're gonna get over it. You know,
I agree.
The movie looks visually beautiful. Where did you guys shoot it?
It's great.
We actually approached Arte Coffee. Obviously, Marcus and Teresa went to Arte Coffee Natalia in Durban.
Mm-hmm.
But we approached the Arte Coffee, and they loved the story. They loved what we were trying to do with black and white. And you know, their resort is open to any race, which is so marvelous. And we actually shot at Arte Coffee Buffelspoort, which is more to Rustenburg side, but it was such a, all the resorts are so beautiful.
Mm.
So it was such an amazing for us to be sitting in one of the resorts, which is, you know, portrays the true story.
Mm. What is your goal for this film? Like, do you have a goal for like an award? Like, do you want to do well in film festivals, or do you have a certain number which you targeted for cinema? Like, maybe you have 1,000 viewers to watch it. Like, what is your goal for this film?
I think our biggest goal is to make sure that, you know, so many people will be able to watch this movie. So it's not just a cinema release. You know, from cinema it goes to box office. From box office it will go to TV and DVD rental, and then it will be available to buy. But you know, we would like so many people to see this movie and to see what impact it can make on their life. We are busy setting up festivals. Like you said, the movie was shot so nicely. We were so privileged to be shooting this movie with the Arri Alexa. Now that sounds Greek. That camera has also been used to shoot Hollywood films.
Yes.
And you can actually see it on the quality of our production. Our wardrobe stands out. It's not the typical wardrobe of most movies. So, I mean, we actually attended to a lot of detail. The color of the movie, the wardrobe, the art department, you know, the amazing stuff. So, and obviously we've got amazing actors, not only well-known A-class actors, but we've got a lot of children and, you know, a couple of unknown actors. So we're looking forward to a couple of festivals coming up, and you know, we believe in writing our film. So definitely we hope to get one or two awards for certain aspects of the movie. So, yeah, we'll have to see, and it all depends on the public. You know, do they like the movie? Don't they like the movie? So far the response was phenomenal.
Oh, that's great. One more question before we go. I just want to know, how can we start the culture of film, making people more interested in going to cinema, like how, besides watching it on TV or DVD, how can we make people more interested before it comes to DVD to go and watch a film?
I think it's a difficult question to answer. I think movies has become expensive. You know, that's one of the problems. You know, I would like to see movies becoming a little bit cheaper in cinema, because you know, it's for a family of four to go watch movies, you know, you can easily walk away with 500 rand if you include the popcorn and the cold drink, that kind of stuff. So it is expensive, but I think, you know, what people must also see in, you know, having the movie experience is that you get to watch it with different people in the same zone cinema, so you laugh with them. As well, I mean, the whole sound, the big screen is quite nice. So I think it's all about marketing, you know, to answer the question, you know, if we can, you know, if we can market the movie, the trailer, you know, and get people excited about it. So I think it comes back to good story. As long as it's a good story, the marketing is good, we can get people back there. But I think you know, price does play a role, and hopefully, you know, people can still afford to go to the movies.
There's a minute here. Please quickly, can you send out a message to young producers, directors, actors? What can they do now to make good quality films here in South Africa? How can they contribute?
I think, you know, I'm also a film school teacher, and this is what I teach my students is, you know, it all starts with a passion. You need to have a passion. Doesn't matter if you're a writer, a producer, a director, or actor. You know, find your passion and live for that passion. And, you know, faith, you know, plays a big role. It's expensive to make movies. But if you have faith in what you are doing, you know, and see it through, you know, you will go far. You will go far. So, you know, two things that's very important for me that I can basically just leave with the listeners is, you know, start with your passion, find your passion in the film industry where you fit in. And the second thing is just have faith. It doesn't matter how many times you fall, it matters how many times you stand up and go for it. It's not an easy industry, but it's a wonderful industry that, you know, as soon as you find your passion, mm-hmm. you know, it's one of the industries that you can go so far in.
Thank you very much. I hope people will go and watch the film here in Mpumalanga. I think you mentioned that it's going to be here in Riverside. I think it's a beautiful film. It's very funny. It looks visually beautiful, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you very much, and thank you for allowing us to talk in your radio station.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks a lot.
I hope you guys enjoyed that interview. I just want to remind you to subscribe to their channel, and if you know someone who's interested in it, please share and of course like, comment there down below. I truly love hearing from you guys. Besides that, enjoy your weekend. See you next time. Mwah!